And everybody, it's Jim Rasier with Free Asset Management. Just before 3:30 here on a Wednesday night, so very quickly, stock nerds and market lovers, I'm losing my voice. Allergies have gotten the best of me here in Texas, so I'm going to try to keep this short so I don't lose my voice and peter out towards the end of the video. But very quickly, stock nerds and market lovers, before we begin, I'm going to talk about there's some trades. I want to show you setups in Ethereum, Bitcoin. I want to go over a couple of stocks. And are the S&Ps, let me be careful here, are the S&Ps at a very high probability short point? We'll talk about that all in one moment, but very quickly, this week's podcast, the tick explosion trade. Listen, this trade presented itself last Friday, and I went over it as it was kind of happening Friday, and then on Tuesday it did again. And so the same thing happened on Tuesday. So towards the top of the show, I get right into it, and you can put that in your quiver and pull that trade out anytime you see the ticks do this at the opening of the market. And so happened on Friday, and then lo and behold, it happened right again on Tuesday, and it is a powerful trade. And so hopefully you're going to watch that if you haven't done so already. And if you did, let me know if you took part in it, because that's a super interesting setup. And then listen, any questions, concerns, comments, take umbrage with anything that I'm saying. All you have to do is hit me up here, tim@riveraasset.com, 855-732-5932. But look, the portfolio team right here, Hunter, Alex, Don, look, we make ourselves available to you. It's a huge differentiation point. You go to stripballadvisor.com and you don't like what's happening, they just do plausible deniability. They blame a mutual fund manager. They blame everybody else but themselves. And they really don't have a course of action other than to switch mutual fund managers. And that's really not a course of action at all. That's just called kicking the can down the road till it fails again. Talk to the people that design your strategy. Talk to the people that execute your strategy. And that's what you get here at Riveraasset with Alex, Don, and Hunter. Listen, you want to talk to America's fiduciary right here. Danny, I'll tell you what, we help a ton of people who have gotten hosed in things like they've been sold life insurance as an investment, or annuities that just trailing fees. Every year you're paying a fee and you don't even know it to the person that sold it to you. So if you have questions like that, 855-732-5932, and let us give you a hand. At the very least, look, if you have any questions, don't just sit there. Whether you're a client, whether you're a stock nerd, market lover, don't just sit there. Just get your questions out. We're here to help and empower. And quite frankly, when you ask questions, we get better. So don't ever sit and look. I'm all day on the tweet machine here at TJ Rasier. There's a little club called, I call them affectionately the IPO Club, and they're just a bunch of stock nerds like you talking about, you know, a video Hunter might have done, or something Alex did a couple weeks ago, and they're just talking stocks. And so it's just a place to congregate with like-minded people that are trying every day to get just a little bit better so they can do the things they want to do in life. And so if you want to entree into that club, it's really no big deal. Just hit me up. I'll introduce you to all the folks on Twitter. And it's at, you can just find me at TJ Rasier, and I can absolutely make that induction to you. Look, there's a message right there. Okay, so with that, stock nerds, market lovers, these videos, what are they for? They're for your edification purposes only. These videos are never, ever to be misconstrued as advice. If you misconstrue these videos of advice, that's on you, pal, not on me, because these videos are for your education, okay? So any questions, concerns about that, just call us, 855-732-8532. So let's do this, let's get S&P. So S&P's here on the hourly chart, you can see that, but when you look here at the daily chart of the S&Ps, interesting here, you know, as I scroll over, the S&Ps have come right up to resistance here. So, you know, it can go either way. It's options expiration week. Right now, is this where they ran them up to short them again? Yeah, I mean, well, it's 2021. So is Jay Powell going to inject some money into the market tomorrow? Buying the dip has been the answer. One day it won't be. But look, this is, you don't want to short. And let me just take it back to an hourly chart real quick. Okay, so here's the hourly chart. And when people say you don't want to shorten the whole, like, you got to kind of come in with your game plan, right? So if your game plan, so there's the hourly chart, and you know where the hole is. Like, you don't want to short when you're approaching the 50 day, and that red line's the 50 day. So here's, you don't want to short here, and you certainly don't want to short here. So you short at where you hit levels of resistance, and you can see the market is getting rejected. Like me on prom, man. Just, hey, we go to the prom thing. No. And so eight comes through the five, or the five comes through the eight, the purple line through the eight, and you're getting rejected at the eight. You're getting rejected at the eight. You can't even make it the eight to make it to the five. You're getting rejected at the eight. And now you're at the 20. You got, listen, big day today, but you got it kind of rejected here at the eight, and now you're pausing at the 21. So that's like your next point to short. Like, that's a high probability shorting area for a ton of algorithms. And so, well, Tim, what if I wanted to short? Well, listen, we're all here to learn, and these videos are for edification purposes only. So you would short, but what if you're wrong? Well, you'll see. It'll start closing twice, once or twice above the 21, and then most likely that short is wrong. It's the wrong trade. But this is, you don't want to short down here. That's shorting in the hole. Shorting at the 50 day is shorting the hole. Well, Tim, what if it went lower? It's a market and anything can happen. But we're looking, like, if you haven't followed my trading for a while, it's probabilistic. I'm looking for high probability moments in time. Shorting around the 21, around rejection of the 8, those are high probability moments in time. It doesn't mean they're going to work. It just means that I've seen more bounces take place at the 50. And you're like, well, Tim, why do those bounces take place at the 50? It's algorithms, man. It's the market. They read the same textbooks you have, and they just programmed the super duper machines to make it all work. And so that's why, at the end of the day, these are just lines on a chart. And in orderly markets, they kind of respect them because of the algorithms. It's when the market receives news that it wasn't expecting that these things just literally become lines on a chart. And you better have a plan, whether the market's, exploding to the upside or just cratering to the downside. And you want to have that plan coming in. So real quick, I got this on the daily chart. Let's look at the NASDAQ here. Super duper quick. So NASDAQ, look, oh, I'm sorry. My ticker swim is not freezing where I leave it. NASDAQ back above the eight. Okay, bounce off the 21 again. That's positivity. I mean, look at Microsoft today, right? Dun, dun, dun. We'll talk about that in a moment. Microsoft saves the market. Let's look at YM though. YMs are a different story. The Dows are a different story here, man. This is weak. These are not healthy here. And so on a weekly chart, look, I get it. No big deal, right? But like, that is not the sign of a healthy. It looks much different than NASDAQ, right? Different than the S&Ps. And so you've got the Dow and the Russell that just, they're choppy. They don't look great. They're kind of anemic, like they need more iron in their diet, stuff like that. And then you've got old perky NASDAQ here, just like Tony the Tiger, great. And then you've got the ES here where, do I want to stay at this party or do I want to ditch it? And I tell you, it's going to be real interesting heading into Friday's expiration. It's the monthly expiration. Do they just want to pull this thing back? And hell if I know. And so you got to come in with a plan of what you want to execute. And what do you want to execute? Well, let's say you were someone like me scanning the charts, like scanning the globe. That's how they used to open My World of Sports, if anybody remembers My World of Sports. Look, I love this type of stuff. This is Bitcoin, right? And so here's Bitcoin. What's my jam, man? Bounce off 21, 5 coming through the purple line, coming through 21, 8, 5 coming through the 8 right now. That's a trigger. Like, and I talk about triggers all the time in the podcast and what I'm looking for. And that's my jam right there. That's a setup. That is a most likely a, if they don't dump Bitcoin overnight, this thing probably goes a little bit higher here. And so, well, how much are, can you show me visually? Well, what would be that second ATR? 52,000. Get a little steam behind it. Maybe you're going back 52,000. Third ATR is so hard to obtain. I know you wick it up here a couple times, but that third ATR will take you back to 55,000. So we'll see. I like Bitcoin here. Just because I like Bitcoin doesn't mean it's moving. But that's my jam. And so you want to be able to scan for that. How about Ethereum? Man, do I like Ethereum. Ethereum to 10,000. That is still my call. And it's the same kind of setup. Now off to 34, off to 21, 5 coming through the 8. All right. Where's Ethereum going to head back to? Well, let's get an ATR chart. You're just quite that one ATR. So two ATR, maybe three ATR, maybe back to 4,000. But like, just because I say, oh, there's the one ATR, there's two ATR, doesn't mean it's going to happen. I can't stress this enough. It's a market. So all the things that we talked about in the past, and maybe if you're newer here, I should go over them in a future video, but like position sizing, right? And what are you trading? Like, are you trading the ATNs? Because there's really no pure ETF in this space. Are you trading the actual coin? Are you buying fractional, like through some app like PayPal, or maybe you're just going right through Coinbase, and you buy fractional, right? So you can position size to take advantage if it moves higher, and also make sure that you're not going to get taken to the cleaners if it should, the trade should fall apart. But where would it fall apart? Like, where would you know you're kind of wrong here if you're not dollar cost averaging in this? Yeah, a couple closes below that mean, below that 21. And where did that happen last? Yeah, like you got this big dump here, this big dump candle after hitting a high. That's a pretty big close below 21. And like, well, Tim, it eventually came back. Yeah, I get it. I mean, maybe one time it doesn't come back. Maybe one time it takes a little too long to come back. And so, you know, below from the 21, once it starts closing below the 21, and these are the futures, so they just trade all the time. So, but what about like, what's from here to here? It's 46%. Right? Like, you don't need to hold on. Like, if you start traveling below the 21, below your where you're not comfortable, you want to be careful, right? If you're dollar cost averaging and you're like, Tim, I just dollar cost average a little bit every month, I don't really care. Hey, man, that's a great plan. And I'm not being facetious one bit when I say it. And kudos to you for the discipline and do it. But coming in with a plan, I think, is crucial. And that sounds so simple. Don't beat me up for it. But look at Microsoft, MSFT. Like, my job, I view in investing, is to find the things that are 21s, you know, finding those support at the pink line here, the mean, and looking for triggers. And look at what triggered yesterday. Yesterday was not a great day for the market. And look at what triggered yesterday. Microsoft, you can't tell me somebody didn't know that they're going to raise a dividend, buy back some stock. They always know, right? Somebody always knows. And so, yeah, and then you get the pop today. Microsoft saves the NASDAQ. And then what about like something like Facebook, right? Bounce off the 21. Well, it hit 34 first. Well, okay, if the NASDAQ breaks down the indice itself, good chance that it drags down a lot of stocks with it. But if you're like, hey, I like to buy the 21 and potentially sell that second or third ATR and I trade options, then, man, that's a plan. So here is, if you're a 21er, Facebook is kind of at your setup, right? And then what about Google? I met with a really awesome dude. Was that Monday? It was Monday. And I just like him. And I'm so glad he came into town. And we're just talking stocks, man. And it's like we never, I haven't seen him in years, but it's not like we've ever, it's just like picking up a conversation where we left off, you know, the last time I saw him. And it was awesome. And it was talking with him at the office. And like, we're talking about Google. And like, Google off 21, right? You know, the mean, where my cursor is, and Google's holding serve. And like, is your plan? What's your plan? Like, you, if you want some Google, right, there it is. It you got a five now coming through the eight. And look, it might not work, but that's why you position size accordingly and you trade within your means. And so, you know, find your moments in time. And when is the last time Google gave you 21s? These are daily charts. And we were talking more weekly charts when I was with him, but daily. You're not getting that many pullbacks to the 21. Listen, big correction, you're going to get all the pullbacks you want. And that's when we're going to really start looking at those weekly charts like I've been talking about for, seems like forever. And then one last one. I was looking at this, saw IPO Club talking about it. YUGI. Yeah, that's 21. You got a trigger. You got a nice consolidation. Let's take this down like a 4 hour. Oh yeah, you see, got this 4 hour like consolidation here. Man, that's Yeti. Now I don't know what Yeti does. I mean, I know what they do, but who knows what the market does tomorrow. But you have to be able to find your setups, your moments in time, and look for those triggers. And Yeti triggered. Yeti's got a little bit of a trigger going on here. So did Google, so a little bit of Facebook, and then ETH and Bitcoin. So study those. You know, let's see how they do the rest of the week. And then I'll most likely follow, let me write this note down in my notebook. I'm going to follow up with these ideas on Friday on the podcast. Let me just write follow Friday. You know what? Maybe that's what the show is this week. Follow up Friday. I'll get Alex in to talk about all the things he's been doing. I'll follow up on some of these. By the way, let's look at Chipotle here. Talk about Chipotle. Just really, it's below 21 here, but not giving up too much ground. And how did Home Depot from the other week go? Really? I mean, just hold and serve. All right. So hopefully that all helps. Listen, I'm sorry my voice is rough. I apologize if you haven't been able to stand the sound in my voice here because of the way the allergies have got me. But anyway, hope you have a great night, and I will see you at the next update.